Some farms are taking precautions now to reduce their water use in preparation for any potential shortage declaration. But efficiency comes at a great cost. Vanessa Barchfield visited with farmers and has more about the challenges they face.
My name is Dan Thielander, and I farm in the Maricopa Stanfield area. And we farm cotton, durum wheat, alfalfa, silage corn.
The Maricopa Stanfield Irrigation District supplies water to Thielander and his neighbors, and it's from a mix of sources.
Traditionally, about half of our water has come from CAP and about half of it has come from groundwater.
CAP water, which comes from the Colorado River, will be less available to farmers in central Arizona in the future. There are a few reasons for that. First, the threat of shortage on Lake Mead.
If we get below 1075, the amount of water available to the state of Arizona is reduced by a certain amount. And that cut really falls to the lowest priority entity, which is the Central Arizona Project. That then translates to the lowest priority users within CAP, which happens to be irrigated agriculture.
That means that the irrigation districts within CAP would lose about 50% of their Colorado River water. Becher says this district would compensate that loss with groundwater.
The challenge there is that puts a large burden on groundwater pumping that, you know, the Irrigation District Board has to decide, do we really want to do that long term?
And there's another piece of the puzzle here. In 2004, Congress adopted a law that resolved long-standing water rights claims for the Gila River Indian Community and the Tohono O'odham Nation. The agreement had ramifications for non-Indian agricultural users as well. They got cheap water in exchange for gradual reductions in CAP allocations. The first 25% cut came in 2017. 2030 is the last year they'll receive any CAP water at that reduced rate.
We will be forced back to close to 100% groundwater production to provide our growers.
And Becher says as more water is drawn out of the ground and levels fall, the cost of pumping it climbs. There are a few other possibilities for supplementing water supply, including leasing water from tribes. But there seem to be two inevitables here. One, in the future, there'll be less water. And two, it'll cost more.
In the meantime, we're the farmers in Pinal County and the CAP districts. We're trying to get as efficient as we can with the water. The efficiency in our district is around 80%. And our farm, we have about 1,000 acres of drip irrigation.
That's about one-fifth of the farm. Drip irrigation would raise Thielander's efficiency to 90 or 95%, but he says he doesn't expect to put any more drip in.
We would like to have our whole farm in drip. We like it, and we make good yields, and it's very efficient with water, but it's just so expensive, we just don't have the money to do that. So that being said, if we had the money and we're facing cutbacks in the future, it doesn't make sense to put in all the acres in drip because we know there's going to be fallowing in Pinal County at some point.
Fallowing is one of the words you hear a lot when talking about farming in this region. It means plots of land that aren't cultivated. Sometimes farmers decide to fallow land to give soil a rest, but increasingly, fallowing is used as a tool to reduce water use. Now, farmers here are often criticized for growing water-intensive crops, like alfalfa, that are exported around the world. Thielander's response to that?
It's an economic activity, just like exporting computer chips that are made at Intel up in Chandler. It takes water to produce that. The crops we produce, they need to go to wherever the market is. And so the world does better with trade, and we're a part of that.
Thielander says he's often asked why he doesn't switch to crops that use less water.
And the answer to that is that we're trying to make a profit. And so, yes, there are crops like barley uses a lot less water than alfalfa or cotton, but the price of barley is so low we'd lose money on every acre that we grow.
Central Arizona's farmers are clearly facing a lot of challenges. But Arnett Duncan of the Duncan Family Farms just west of Phoenix says there is a future for agriculture in this region.
I think it'll be really interesting to see which crops are economically feasible here which ones are politically allowed here, because I think that's, you know, water is going to be all about, you know, a legislative process of policy and who gets the water and who gets to use it and what is the greatest and highest end use.
Duncan is in a different irrigation district than Thielander, but they face a lot of the same water issues. This farm is 100% organic, and Duncan says that helps him as he looks forward to a future where water costs more.
This is a demonstration of a crop or an example of a crop that can support a higher cost for water, irrigation water, especially if it's applied efficiently.
And water efficiency is one of Duncan's main priorities.
We really have to be conserving now. It's not as if we can wait for some magic number as a level of a lake to hit where then we start to save water. Literally every day at our house here on the farm, it doesn't matter, we're looking to conserve water. And we should start now. No, we should have started years ago.
Back in Pinal County, Brian Betcher says he sees opportunities over time for farmers to switch to higher value crops like organic fruits and vegetables. And some growers are partnering with the Environmental Defense Fund to test other crops that could use less water. Like Duncan, Betcher also sees a future for farming here, though he says the region will look very different.
I would like to think that there's a proper balance that will allow a gradual decline in farming down here, but keep it profitable to balance the needs of the state. I'm a firm believer that every state ought to have a significant component of farm ground to provide direct supplies of food and fiber to the population in the state. The society, the public policy has got to get on board and agree that that's a value. And if it is, I think we'll make the water supplies available and we'll find that balance.